So we were discussing in section 4.4.3 addition of angular momenta, and we proved that there were two different configurations. One configuration was the triplet configuration, which was state 1, 1, and then state 1, 0, and state 1, -1. And these were equal to spin up, and then means both the spin were up. This was the composite system. Composite means the electron and proton together. This was the total spin of the hydrogen atom. So it is equal to this. Then this state was equal to 1/2, and it is up and down, plus down and up, and this was like this. So we were having the addition of these, and then it was down and down when both the spin are down. This whole configuration gives the spin quantum number equal to 1, and we called it a triplet configuration or triplet state. So triplet configuration. Similarly, one of the system or one of the configuration with 0, 0, this is equal to 1√2, and then it is up and down with a minus sign, down and up, and this is for spin quantum number 0, and this is the singlet configuration. So first understand this thing, that we were having two particle system. And this two particle system is a hydrogen atom, in which we are having an electron and we are having a proton. This electron is having spin half, and this proton is with spin half. There is a possibility that both the spin will be up. Okay, when both the spins will be added, means both are plus half, we will get one configuration, we will get one state of the whole system of the hydrogen atom. The other possibility is that both the spins are down, and we will get another state. In this one the spin is 1, while in this one the spin is 1. There is another possibility that if one is up and the other is down, the other is down and the one is up. So in that situation, we will again have our spin equal to, S will be equal to 1, while M will be equal to 0. So for this one, S is equal to 1 and M is having three values, 1, 0 and minus 1. This is with 1, this is with minus 1, and this one is with 0. There is another possibility that 0 is coming out, S is equal to 0, so M is equal to 0. The two spins are up and down, but they are being subtracted. So additional state is coming out, and we call this state as a singlet state, while this is a triplet state. Clear? So this is the situation. Now we will check that both of these states, whether it's a triplet state or it's a singlet state, they will be the eigenstates of S squared. S being the total spin. And if it is S squared, then it means the square of the total spin is, we have calculated, capital L squared. This is having associated quantum number, which is small s. This is having associated quantum number, which is small l. This is having a component, the total spin component, sz. Similarly, this one is having lz. Sz, so this is capital S and capital L, the z component of the total angular, the orbital angular momentum, the z component of the spin angular momentum. This one is having associated quantum number, which is the orientation under a certain magnetic field, ML, and this is having MS, right? Magnetic spin quantum number, magnetic orbital quantum number. So these are under magnetic field. These are the orientations of their angular momenta under the application of magnetic field. So we will now check that whether it's a triplet combination or configuration, or it's a singlet configuration, these are the eigenfunctions of S squared. And when they are the eigenfunctions of S squared, the eigenvalue they have is 2 h bar squared. You can treat S as a vector, because you know that when S is a vector, it is having three components, Sx, Sy, and Sz. So Sx and I, Sx and Sy and J, and Sz and K. When you will write S square, so S square, just like vectors, it is S dot S. And it will be Sx multiplied with Sx. It will be a dot product. You know that similar components and dot product, they multiply. So this is Sx times Sx, and it will cause this Sx whole square plus Sy times Sy and Sz times Sz, and this will be equal to S squared. So Sx square plus Sy whole square plus Sz whole square. Clear? Now I would like to write S square in a little bit different way. Different way is due to the reason that you remember that for the electronic state we are having 1s. And for the nucleus or protonic state, we are having another S. So this S squared, I can write that it is composed of two, like S1 plus S2 and whole square. Because this S1 will operate on state 1, which is the electronic spin. S2 will operate on the proton spin. Clear? This we have done already. So this will be, its whole square will be equal to the dot product of this with another this. And I can write that this is S1 plus S2 dot, means these are vectors, okay? So if I forget to write the vector symbol, you should put it here, and then S1 plus S2, and they are under a dot product. Now what this will cause is one is will have a dot product with this one. So it will become S1 whole square. S1 will have a dot product with S2. Then S2 will have a dot product with S1. So dot product is commutative. So you can write this one two times S1 dot S2. And then S2 will be dot product with S2. So it will be S2 whole square. So I can write this one is this is equal to S1 whole square plus S2 whole square plus 2 times S1 dot S2. Is it right? These will remain as vectors. Clear? Now, you also know that what will be S1 whole square. Because S is having three components, Sx, Sy, and Sz. So it will have three components, and I will write S1 is this will be S1 will be first, it will be Sx1. Sx1, it will be like I write the vector plus Sy1 plus Szn1. Similarly, S2 will be Sx2, Sy2, Sz2, and so on. So I can write that. Let me write the very first term that I want to find. I want to find this one, which is S1 into S2. So I will first find out this one, which is this value. I will first find out. So this value is equal to S1 dot S2, and these are vectors. So this is equal to and let me apply this on one zero state. Because you see that this state is straightforward, while this state is straightforward, this state is a bit complex. So I will prove here that S square, this state, one of the configuration from the triplet state, this one is a complex one, so I will take this one, that this is an eigenstate. This is an eigenfunction of S square with an eigenvalue 2 h bar square. All will come out, all the states will be with this value. Because here we are having S equal to 1. So let's start with this state, which is the first one. Means I apply it on this portion first. This portion. And it is the up and down combination. And this is equal to, I will now write S1. So split this one. Let me first write and then I will explain. Sx1, and it will apply on this up here. Then Sx2, and it will apply on this down here. The rest will be just the symmetry. Look here. S1 dot S2, when you will multiply them, then the x component of this one is 1 will be multiplied with the x component of this one. So the x component of 1 and the x component of 2. Now I know that when sx1 is applying, it will apply on the first one, which is spin up, while the second one is 2 will apply on the second one, because the one, this has nothing to do with it, and it is applied on this one. And now I will repeat the symmetry, and the symmetry will be sy1 will operate on this up, and sy2 will operate on this down. Clear? This is fine? Similar components of sy and sy of 1 and 2, this will have application on up because it is state 1, and this is on the state 2. Plus, then we will have sz, and this is 1 and applied on up, while sz state 2 and it is applied on down. Clear? So this is the S1 and S2. What I will do? I will apply S square, which is actually this whole thing. S1 square, S2 square. I will find S1 square on this one. I will find S1 square on this statement. Then S2 square on this, S2 square on this. And at the end, I will find 2 times S1 dot S2 here on this as well as this. So first, I am finding out the last term here on this one. Then I will find this whole on this one as well. And I will add them up. Clear? So keep the steps in mind. And now, applying this on it. And you know about the Sx, you know about the Sy, and you know about the Sz. What was Sx? It was h bar would 2. And here, what was the spin matrix? 0, 1, 1, 0. What was Sy? I h bar would 2, keep the I out. And it was? 0 minus, because it was 0 minus I 0, so we have taken I out. What was SZ? H bar equal to 0 1 minus 1. Confirm this one. Okay. Yes, it is minus 1. Clear? So 0 minus 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. Yes. The 2 having minus, the Sx is not having any minus.